Hey guys, today we're going to bleed the cooling system on our 350Z. Now, Nissan makes an awesome product all around. It's a beautiful platform, great engine, it just works really well. However, I have a couple nitpicky things, and they don't seem to be really good at hydraulic systems or cooling systems. The reason why I say that, when it comes to bleeding the brakes or bleeding the cooling system, it usually just takes way longer to do on these cars and requires a few more steps. Now, the first thing you want to do is you want to get the front end of the vehicle higher, whether you want to jack it up, put on ramps, maybe you have an aggressive enough driveway, as long as the front end is higher than the rear. What that's going to do is it's going to allow those air bubbles to travel up towards the front of our radiator. You'll also want to have your parking brake on. It can be in neutral, or you can leave it in first while you're working on it, but when you get in, you're gonna have to either put in neutral or push the clutch in, obviously. And remember, if you're raising the front of the vehicle, to secure the rear wheels. Now, those of you that are servicing a street vehicle, you're gonna have a heater core. If you have a race car and you've deleted this, you don't have to worry about this. So the first thing we're gonna do is we're gonna make sure that the HVAC temperature is on the highest possible setting. You can put the fan setting on medium or high, whatever makes you guys feel comfortable. Remember, the heater core uses the coolant heat to give heat inside the vehicle. So we have to open that up and make sure everything works because the coolant is involved with this whole process. So here's a mod I highly recommend that you guys get. It is the coolant bleeder from Z1 Motorsports. So it is all metal construction, much more durable, a lot easier to work with. So if yours is damaged, I would go ahead and switch up to one of these. Don't get the factory one again. So if we take a look back here, you see this little area over here? This is what's going to help you bleed the system. You just use a big flathead screwdriver with it. You can see here, it doesn't really accept the Phillips that well. For those of you using the factory bleeder, I know you're going to grab a number 2 Phillips, doesn't fit that well. Then you're going to grab a number 3 Phillips and you're like, well, this is too big, but it works. Try using the Japanese industry standard bit. And you can see that their design is very similar to number 2, but shaped differently. And you might have better luck with using something like that. This is typically what we see on the brake rotors, and you know, you grab a different Phillips and it kind of works. They actually have a standardized bit for their stuff. In order to bleed the system, we need to make sure that our thermostat's working properly. So if you have a thermostat that's stuck closed, well, it's not going to get the coolant flowing throughout the whole system. It's just going to kind of stay in the engine. If it's stuck open, you can bleed it, but I would still change it out. So make sure that your thermostat is working properly. We're about to fill the cooling system with fluid again. So you can see here we have a special funnel with an adapter. This allows us to basically make the job easier because it's a lot easier to fill it. I can fill this up to a third of the way full, and this will take in the fluid as I run the engine, and this will help eliminate any air bubbles. Now, you still might get air and you're gonna have to bleed the system, but this is gonna make life a lot easier because now this is the highest point. We're gonna leave the vehicle the way it is with the engine up higher than the rear, and we're also gonna come over here to the bleeder screw. See it over here, take your big screwdriver, and we're going to open it up. As we fill this, according to the service manual, we want fluid to come out of here first. That's even before you even run the engine. We're going to fill this up as slowly as we can. About to pull out. There we go. Up, up. So now we can go ahead and close our bleeder screw. So traditionally, if you squeeze it, you can get some air bubbles, but we're just pushing air out. But we had some bubbles come out. But we're going to leave it at a third, and we're going to run the engine and let the engine take in the coolant and keep topping it off. We're about to run the engine. Make sure you're in neutral. Set the heat up high and turn on your fan. I can see the bucket from here, so I keep an eye on it. So we're reading our instructions. And basically it says rev the engine to approximately 2500 RPM for 10 seconds, let idle, do this a few times. turn the engine off and let it cool and add more coolant mixture, bring level back. So we don't have to, the nice thing about that is I don't have to keep checking the level, I can just see it from here. So we're gonna bring it to 2500. We're gonna do that a few times. Right now we're waiting for the vehicle to get up to operating temperature because we need the thermostat to open so that way the coolant starts flowing through the block. See it bubbling though, it's starting to release air.
Yeah.
My cooling fan is just turned on and a bunch of level went down, so it seems that the thermostat is opening. So we are just trying to get more air out of the system right now. We weren't lying, this is a very time consuming process. As I'm cycling the engine at 2500 RPM and holding it, I have to keep coming and refilling because it's still taking air. I would also let it cool down a couple times. I had to open up the bleeder just a little bit. I didn't release it all the way because it is hot, but when you release the bleeder valve, you can hear a hissing sound. There's air. So now I'm starting to get hot air in the car, which means it's circulating properly. So I refilled again. We're gonna do the cycle a few more times. Don't tap the accelerator, like give it quick revs because you want to hear your exhaust. I did that and then air just started blowing in cold. So basically I would see the water come up and come back down. I must have been sucking air back into the system. So just hold it at 2500 RPM when you're doing this. Don't do quick revs until you have your cooling system resealed with your radiator cap back on. You see here where the vehicle cooled down, it has taken everything from our funnel. So we're going to take this off and see how close we are up to the filler neck. Looking pretty good. Before we button everything up, you want to double check, our drain plug, check all the lower hoses over here, make sure that we have no leaks, and give it a quick wipe down, and then go ahead and put the belly pan back on. Now let's say you're done your test drive, and you've driven it, you put a lot of heat into the engine up to normal operating temperature, and you feel like you have to bleed the system more at the bleeding screw. Do not do it when it's hot. This is a pressurized system. If that caps on there, and you open that up, that could be a bit dangerous. You might have something spurt out and you can get hurt. So let the vehicle cool down a bit if you decide to open up that bleeder. Now for this job, what we like to do is we like to get factory filled Nissan fluid, it's a concentrate, and then we get distilled water from the grocery store or the drugstore and we mix it 50-50. Now, this can change for your mixture depending on your requirements because coolant is great. It has a very high boiling point, but it can't heat exchange that well. While pure water is awesome at exchanging heat, but it has a very low boiling point. So when you mix it, you get a blend. So there are different ratios you can do, but if you're not sure, just go 50-50. So there's a variety of different coolants. Make sure you get one that's compatible with your system. There's different colors you can get. That's why I just make it easy for myself. I just grab the stuff from the dealership. Now, another good bang for your buck product is if you're trying to raise the boiling point of your coolant, we can actually install a high pressure radiator cap. So be careful with this. You don't want to go too crazy because if you put a ton of pressure into it, if you somehow find a radiator cap that really pushes the limits of your cooling system, that's not going to be good. But going with a credible brand like this is definitely going to help. And remember, when you're doing that bleeding procedure, really take your time. You know, you could be on it for 20 minutes up to 45, depending on how quick your engine can actually get up to operating temperature. So just be patient when you do it. So hopefully, guys, these little tips help you out. I know these cars are a little bit finicky when it comes to things like this, but once you understand them, it's not really that bad.